Now, whether they're to make you look good or make you able to look at all, sunglasses are a modern day necessity.
Absolutely. Remember that saying, slip, slop, slap and rap? Mm-hmm. Well, the rap is not like boom, ba-dum, ba-dum, the rap is the sunglasses. Did I explain that correctly?
Thank you for clarifying. Mm. Yes, but with so many options out there ranging so vastly in price, we wanted to know if a cheap pair of sunnies can do the same job as an expensive pair. Hannah investigates.
It's a simple enough question. Can a $10 pair of sunnies do the same job as a $400 pair? Or are some sunglasses just too cheap for our peepers?
This pair that I have now cost me like 20 bucks, I think. 10 bucks.
$20 maybe? Maybe 20 bucks.
Just looking up.
We didn't muck around with this one. We went for an expert's opinion.
That's great, just looking straight ahead.
Dr. Andrew Collins runs the School of Optometry at Auckland University. He's very big on doing right by our sight.
The cornea effectively can be sun damaged much in the same way as skin, so you can get sunburn of the cornea.
It can happen up on the mountains, for instance. When it's really bad, it's called snow blindness.
It's a bit grey when you're skiing, and so people take off their glasses because they think they can see better without them on, which may be true, but they're still exposed to quite a lot of ultraviolet. It can be very painful and actually quite debilitating.
Is it long term at all?
It's like sunburn, it takes a while to recover.
And if you're getting repeat blasts of eye burn, think yachties, surfies, people working outdoors, you can get growths called pinguiculae. They're really common. Less common are pterygiums, which can affect your eyesight. This one belonged to cricketer Ross Taylor and he needed surgery, so...
Protecting your eyes from light, high intensity light, bright light, is a really good idea.
So that's covered off the why of sunglasses. Let's get to the how much.
How much is that?
$3.
Maybe 200 max.
200.
And for baby?
Like $4, $12, I think I spent on hers, yeah.
Somewhere around $200.
Last pair I got was free, so.
And are people basing their sunglasses choices on style or protection?
I'd say style.
I like style.
UV protection.
So style?
A UV protection, the lenses, yeah. And then the style.
As that completely unscientific sampling showed, lots of people are buying cheapy sunglasses. Are they risking their eyesight? Back to Dr. Andrew to test a range of sunglasses from $12 to $400 to see which ones do the job.
Can reset.
The top figure displays how much glare is getting through the glasses. That's the visible light. The bottom figure is how much invisible light, UV, ultraviolet, is getting through. Ideally, none.
Really, for sunglasses, you expect to see zero or very close to zero. For visible light, you'll see a range somewhere between about 43 and 9 for standard sunglasses, so that's how much light's being transmitted.
So it's a measure of how dark the tint is. If your glasses have an 80% tint, then only 20% of light will be getting through.
Pop these in, you can see the top one goes down to about 15, 16.
Which means these glasses have an 84% tint.
All and they're right. Nice dark tints, so they'll give you lots of comfort from sun glare. And the bottom number there goes down to zero, so they're blocking all the ultraviolet.
Just what you'd expect from $400 glasses. But what about the $20 or $30 pair you might buy at a service station?
And again, okay. You're seeing a number like 15, about an 85% tint.
An 85% tint means good coverage from the cheapies and...
So again, zero UV as well.
So let's try a really cheap pair.
OK, let's have a look at the $12 ones, because these have got unicorns on them. We pop them in. And we go down to 14 again, so much the same as the other ones we've tested.
Yes.
Zero ultraviolet.
The results were both surprising and reassuring.
So, in fact, $10 sunglasses can work just as well as $400 ones.
But since most of us don't carry a machine like this around when we're shopping for shades, this is what you look for. This confirms the glasses meet the New Zealand-Australian standards. Or you might see this, which means the glasses conform to European standards. Or look for this international standards symbol.
As long as they claim to meet one of those standards, you can be pretty reassured.
You can be reassured by that.
Your sunnies might also have a category tag. 2 and 3 are good. Category 0 and 1 mean the tint's too light to protect your eyes. Category 4 means too dark to be safe for driving.
What's the cheapest pair of sunglasses you've ever bought?
If I needed them, I'd buy $10 ones as long as I saw a standard mark on them.
You'd be happy with that?
Yep.